Now this is our fourth video for the cathode ray oscilloscope. In this video we discuss how the sine wave pattern we can see on the screen of the CRO, and also we discuss about the different parts of the CRO. Thank you. Up to this fourth lecture of CRO, we already discuss about vertical amplifier, trigger circuit, time-based generator, horizontal amplifier, screen, CR tube, two deflecting plates, vertical and horizontal, right? Now, unknown signal it is given to the input, and the time-based generator, that time-based generator produces the sawtooth wave. To the horizontal deflecting plates. Why we are applying sawtooth wave to the horizontal deflecting plates? That we will see. Now, what happened when we are applying sawtooth wave to the horizontal deflecting plates? That we will see. And also, what is the input signal? What is our input signal? Maybe it is sine wave, maybe it is square wave, maybe it is triangular wave. That is depending upon which type of the waveform that we want to see on the screen of the CRO. First of all, when we are applying sawtooth signal, always in x-axis, that means time axis, that means in between the two horizontal deflecting plates, we are applying only sawtooth wave. There is an external switch, through which we can apply any other signal, but most of the time we are applying sawtooth wave. Why we are applying sawtooth wave and how the unknown signal present on the screen of the CRO, that we will see here. What happened when we are applying sawtooth wave? So this is our two screen of the CRO, right? This is our x1, x2, two horizontal deflecting plates. This is our v1, v2. At present, we are not applying any signal to the V1, V2. We are applying X1, X2, sawtooth wave. This is our sawtooth wave. Like this. Right? This type of the waveform we are applying in between X1 and X2. And this waveform is generated by the time-based generator. Right? Now, if we are applying this type of the signal, what happened? See, we are considering this is your minus 5, this is your minus 2 volt, we consider that. This is our 0 volt, this is our plus 5, and this is our, plus 2, and this is our plus 5. If we are applying this type of the sawtooth wave in between x1, x2, then how the spot moves? So at the time t1, this is your time t1, t2, t3, t4, and this is your t5. Right? At time t1, we see that left hand side x1 is maximum negative. Left hand side x1 is maximum negative. So our spot is moves maximum left hand side. At the time t2, this is our time t2. The left hand side plate is minus 2 volt, that means less than minus 5. So it moves right hand side and it is now here. At that time T3, the voltage between, potential difference between X1 and X2, the voltage is 0, so it is in the center. Why it is in the center? Because there is no voltage in between V1 and V2. Right? So the spot is in the center. Now, at that time T4, the voltage is plus 2 volt, so beam moves right hand side, it is now here. At that time T5, the right hand side is maximum positive plus 5 volt, so the beam is maximum right hand side. This phenomena, after this, the waveform is touched to the 0, right? That means this, and again 0, that means left hand side maximum 0, right? This waveform is continuous So we are getting continuous this type of the waveform, which is known as x-axis, which is known as x-axis. In this way, we are using this sawtooth wave for developing x-axis on the screen of the CRO. That's why we are using maximum time sawtooth wave for the preparation or presenting the unknown signal on the screen of the CRO. Now we are discussing what happened when we are applying sine wave. If we want to see sine wave on the screen of the CRO, how this sine wave generate. So before we see this, we will see what happened when the sine wave is given to the y-axis and no voltage is given to the x-axis. So this is our screen. We are applying sine wave. If our unknown waveform is sine, we are applying sine wave. Right? Our sine wave is like this. If our sine wave is like this, so we can see there is no voltage in between the x1, x2. There is a voltage is h1. A sine wave at h1, h2. So initial condition t1, t2, t3, t4, and this is your t5. Right? T1 condition, this is your t1. T1 condition, the waveform is, there is no voltage between v1, v2. There is a zero voltage. So this is your center. Spot is in the center. In T1 condition, upper terminal, upper plate is maximum, so the spot moves maximum. At T3, it is again zero. It is again zero, so spot moves here. Right? At T4, lower terminal, lower plate is maximum, so the spot is here. And at T5, again it is zero, so spot is here, right? So if this waveform is continuously, so the spot moves continuously here, we are getting the y-axis, right? So in this way, if there is no voltage in between vertical, we are applying sawtooth wave, again we are getting x-axis. If we are applying sine wave, we are getting y-axis. If both the voltage we are getting given to the circuit, then the resultant position we are getting resulting position of this waveform. How it is produced, right? How the sine wave is produced. So for this is our diagram. This is our diagram, right? How to discuss this diagram here? So we have the screen is this. The screen is this. X1, X2. Y1, Y2. Y1, Y2. We are applying sine wave. X1, X2, we are applying sawtooth wave, and on the screen we are getting sine wave. Okay. How this is possible, right? So for this we are getting resulting position. Is sine wave on the screen. For this, see, this is the graph. In this graph, this is x axis. We are applying sawtooth wave. Y axis, we are applying this type of the sine wave, right? At t0 second, left hand side is maximum negative, which is here given minus E2. T1 max less than this but not 0, minus E1. At time t2, it is 0 second, 0 voltage, 0 voltage on x plate is, and 0 voltage on y plate. T3, right hand side more positive. T4, right hand side plate is maximum positive, right? Right hand side plate is maximum positive. Y axis, we are applying sine wave. Starting t0 second, it is 0 volt. T1 maximum upper, t2 0, t3 maximum lower, t4 again 0, right? Be careful this, right? So what happened here, when we start from t0 second, the screen is like this. What is your x-axis? Again, left hand side plate is maximum, right? Because this is x-axis, 0, center, left hand side, so our spot is here, right? Resulting position, y-axis upar ki taraf jayega nahi, kyunki y-axis is 0. In between two horizontal plate, maximum left hand side is maximum voltage, so spot is moving left hand side, right? At T1, what happened in x axis? There is some right hand side position because the voltage is decreasing, so it is right hand side position like this, right hand side. But at that time, in y axis, it is maximum. In y-axis, it is maximum. So at T2, it is maximum upper side. So the spot is right hand side, maximum upper side. Okay. This is our resulting position. At T2, y-axis 0, that means this axis is 0. At T2, y-axis 0, that means this. And what about x-axis? X-axis is also 0. So this is your this point. Right? At T3 position, what happened? At T3 position, x-axis right hand side more positive. That means here. But resulting position of y-axis is maximum negative. Maximum negative, that means lower terminal is maximum negative. That means we are getting this point. At T4, we are getting right hand side is maximum. And what about y-axis? Y-axis is 0. So we are getting this way, right? So we connect this point, we are getting the sine wave. Right? You understand this? So we are completely understanding this step by step. See here what happened. Here we see, again I repeat, T0. Now at time T0, the sweep voltage or sawtooth voltage is minus E2. And the negative horizontal voltage moves the spot to the point 1 on the screen. At this instant, the signal voltage is 0, so the spot rests at the left end of the 0 line on the screen. At the time T1, the linearity increases, so it reaches minus E1, which being more positive than minus E2, moves the spot to the screen point 2. At this instant, the signal voltage is E, the positive peak value, so the point represents its maximum upward direction of the spot. At time t2, the sawtooth voltage is zero, there is no horizontal deflection, and the spot is at the center point 3. At this instant, signal voltage is zero, so there is no vertical deflection either. At time t3, the sawtooth voltage is more positive. T3, this is your T3, the sawtooth voltage is more positive. That means plus even, moving the spot to the point 4. At this instant, the signal is negative, the negative peak value, so point 4 is maximum downward deflection of the spot, like this. At time T4, the sawtooth voltage is plus E2. At time T4, the sawtooth voltage is at maximum position E2, right? Like this. Moving the spot to the point 5. Now the signal voltage is 0, so the spot is not vertically deflected. I repeat, at time T4, the sawtooth voltage is plus E2, moving the spot to point 5. Now the signal voltage is 0, so the spot is not vertically deflected. Between T4 and T5, the sawtooth voltage falls quickly. The sawtooth voltage falls quickly through 0 to its initial value of minus E2, snapping the spot back to the point 1 in time to sweep forward on the next cycle of the signal voltage. When sweep and signal frequency are equal, a single cycle appears on the screen. When the sweep is lower than the signal, several cycles appears. And when sweep is higher than the signal, less than one cycle appears. The display is stationary only when the two frequencies are either equal or integer multiple of each other. At other frequency, the display will drift horizontal. So in this way, the resulting position of the X plate, Y plate voltages, we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, this type of the waveform we are getting on the screen. This is display of on screen. See, this type of the waveform display on the screen. The process is continuously sawtooth waveform and sine wave given to the two vertical and horizontal deflecting plates, and we are getting the continuous, this type of the sine wave pattern gets on the screen of the CR. Now we are discussing about the whole structure of the CRO. This, right? This is our whole structure of the CRO. So one by one, we already discuss about all this. One by one, we repeat. This is our simple CRO. The basic block diagram of simple CRO is given here. The AC filament supplies power to the CRT heaters. Where is our heater? This is our heater. This also provides an accurate AC calibration voltage. CRT DC voltage is obtained from the high voltage DC supply. Where this is our high voltage DC supply, right? There is a voltage divider R1 to R5, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 are the voltage divider circuit. See here, what is minus 15 degree and what is minus 300, so we consider that this is our minus 100. So in between this, there is a rheostat, and this is our plus 300 volt. We consider that, right? This is our ground, right? In between this is plus 300 plus voltage. In between this is here our minus voltage. What is the difference between this? Difference between this, you know that there is a battery. In open. You are applying this type of the battery. Here plus 5 volt, here minus 5 volt, and here ground. Right? In op-amp, you are applying plus 5 volt or minus 5 volt. Here you are applying plus, here you are applying minus, and ground. This is your inverting terminal, non-inverting terminal, and this is your output. You know this, right? So there is no plus minus, but there is a potential difference. What is the voltage? Voltage is the force in the, this is, we consider like this, right? This is our pipe, panini pipe, right? If this is our starting point and this is our ending point, right, then this is our ground terminal and this is our plus terminal. Whatever the charge in this conductor which is passing in this direction, it is our positive terminal and this is our negative terminal, or we can say ground terminal, right? And it is, voltage is our potential difference. This is our potential difference with a some reference point. This is our reference point, then this voltage is plus. If this is our reference point, then this voltage is negative with respect to this point. Again, I repeat, with respect to this point. So this is our minus 500 to 300 volt. So here, same thing is given. This is high voltage supply, and in between low voltage supply, there is a connection of, these are the different R1, R2, R3, R4. It is nothing but, it is our potentiometer. Included along with this voltage divider is a potentiometer which varies the potential at the focusing electrode, known as focus control, and one which varies the control grid voltage, called the intensity control. So this is our intensity control knob, right? If we increase the voltage, that means we change the reverse state here, then the more voltage is given to the intensity control knob, control grid. So intensity is, we can increase or decrease the intensity. Same way, this is our R3, it is connecting here, so we can change the focusing, we can focus the our structure or our spot on the screen of the CRO, right? So there are two variable, intensity control and focusing control. This is our intensity control and this is our focusing control. This intensity control and focusing control knob, it is given front panel of the CRO. Now then, capacitor C1 here is used to ground the deflection plates and the second anode for the signal voltage, but DC isolates these electrodes from the ground. Normally S2, where is S2? This is our S1, this is our S2. Normally S2 is set to its linear position. This connect the sweep generator. Normally S1, it is connect to the sweep generator, that means sawtooth generator. That means normally we are applying sweep voltage, that means our sawtooth voltage, right? So this gives us the x-axis on the screen of the CRO. Normal CRO, mostly we are using sawtooth voltage, so it is our S1. Normally S2 is set to its linear position. This connect the sweep generator, right? This connect the sweep generator output to the horizontal input. The sweep voltage is amplified before being applied to the horizontal deflecting plates. When an externally generated sweep is desired, S2 is connected to its external position and the external generator is connected to the input. The sweep synchronizing voltage is applied to the internal sweep generator, through which S1, which select the type of synchronization. That means S2 horizontal input, or S2 it is connected externally. So whatever the external signal, it is synchronized. Same way S1, it is connected to the internal or external sync input. In this way, this is our power supply, this is our heater ne alag se voltage dene ke liye hota hai, the three different plate electrodes, accelerating anode, focusing anode and final anode, two deflecting plates, and this is our CRT, right? So this is your complete structure of the what is inside the CR. That's all. Thank you.